This is the home of Octave, and the stables are untouched. So there hasn't been any change over all these years.
Today we are here to honor Octave de Smet. When he was 22 years old, he decided that he wanted to emigrate to the United States of America. So he went across the ocean and settled down in Michigan and got a job in Michigan. It was a flower hander for the Sault Ste. Marie Railroad Company. By all accounts, he had intended to make this a permanent move. There was no indication he intended to come back to Belgium. But World War I broke out. When America entered the war, they instituted the draft. He was one of the first class of people to register for the draft, and he was drafted in June of 1918 into the American Army.
This was like a sixth contingent. Honor man, I called April 29, 1918.
Okay. In August of 1918, he was sent here to Europe. He was assigned to the 4th Infantry Regiment, which was heavily engaged in the combat in the Meuse-Argonne region of France. Basically, his unit saw continuous combat from the 21st of September to the 1st of November 1918 in the Meuse-Argonne. And they suffered 80% casualties in that period. This number so shocked the French that the French government awarded the entire regiment the Croix de la Guerre afterwards. Octave de Smet was one of these people who was killed in that period of time. He died on the 23rd of October 1918, suffered of wounds received during an artillery barrage.
The willingness to literally put his life on the line for his country, and both his native born country of Belgium, and then also to fight for the U.S., knowing that, you know, the odds could be against him.
It's important for me for the next generation. That's why I wanted the schools to be here, the youth, because nobody knows anymore what it is to have famine, to have hunger, to have war.